Going to explain you about the types of curses. There are actually four types of curses, that is static, dynamic, fast forward and keyset dynamics. In this video I'm going to cover about the static cursor. Actually this static cursor is a cursor when it populates the result set during the cursor creation only, and the query result is cached for the lifetime of the cursor. This static cursor can move forward or backward or in between. It has a scroll option also. So actually this static cursor, it actually do not detect the changes made by the member whenever this after the cursor is opened. Like whenever if you want to see anybody changes the data in that particular table, the cursor, it will not update that updated data. It uses the data only when the cursor is created. That time the data is used. So let me explain you about the static cursor. Here I have declared these variables. See, I have declared a cursor here and cursor is of a static. First select star from employee group details. This is the data which we have, and I have opened fetch data, and this is out for if employee ID, if percentile limit, if its remainder is equal to zero, then I have searched that print this data is printed. So for even numbers, like if we can say like all the even numbers, employee ID with the even numbers, the data is selected and displayed. See, if I open this, execute, see 2, 4, 6, 10, this is the data we will be getting. So this is how a static cursor is work. Means like if you like in this static cursor, usually it is only the read only cursor. Means that means if you want to any update or change the data, it will not be done. So whenever the static cursor, the data will be the same whenever the data is created. In this example here, I have explained you about the static cursor, that if and I have done like update, I have done the update to this employee, like update to this cursor. See, if I execute this, the same thing, here what does it do? A cursor with the name employee cursor, I did not close this one here, so it is again I have to close this employee cursor and deallocate the cursor. Okay, now I am creating this one with the update statement. So what does it do? Actually it gives an error message like the cursor is read only. Means in this static cursor, we cannot modify the data. Whatever the data when we have created, that data will be there. Whenever we doesn't want any changes in the data, and that time we can use this type of static cursor. Static cursor is a best choice for that. So here I have done some modification, so it did not apply. So the other thing is this employee cursor, we can use as a scroll also. Like we can get the data from this, like already I have explained about the scroll fetching of data from this fetching the data from the cursor. So there are some options, are there 6 options are there fetching the data in the scroll option. That one I have written here, like I have already explained this about in the previous video, so you can check for that. Here if we, that the same thing, the static cursor like this static cursor can be done like anywhere, like data can be collected from forward or backward or bin between or anywhere we can do it. So I'm executing this. So this is how we have executed. Let's see all the data we have got it. Like in this static cursor, we can get the fetch the data by using scroll option also, the basic thing in the static cursor is that we cannot modify the data in this cursor. And the other thing is, whenever the data which is fetched first, the data will be the same until last. We cannot modify if the other application member has updated the data, it will not affect this cursor. So these are the things we have to think about in a static cursor. Thank you for listening.